Welcome everyone to this PowerPoint presentation titled How to Prove from the Bible that There Are 30 Days in a Biblical Month. This is very important to know in order to understand the time prophecies of the Bible correctly. Before we get started, I'm going to say a word of prayer. Dear Father in Heaven, we ask that you be with us right now. Please forgive us of our sins. Send your Holy Spirit, Lord, that we are so dependent upon, that we may have an understanding of your truth. Help us to see this teaching very clearly. We thank you and we praise you in Jesus' name. Amen. The time will come when we shall be brought before councils and before thousands for his name's sake, and each one will have to give the reason of his faith. Then will come the severest criticism upon every position that has been taken for the truth. We need then to study the Word of God, that we may know why we believe the doctrines we advocate. One of the doctrines we advocate is the time times in half a time, or 1,260-year prophecy equals 1,260-day prophecy equals 3.5 years. Well, in order to prove that, we have to prove that there's 30 days in a month. So we'll be going over that today. This last quote was Last Day Events, page 209, paragraph 1. Many will have to stand in the legislative courts. Some will have to stand before kings and before the learned of the earth to answer for their faith. Those who have only a superficial understanding of truth will not be able clearly to expound the scriptures and give definite reasons for their faith. They will become confused. Let no one imagine that he has no need to study because he's not to preach in the sacred desk. Last Day Events 209, paragraph 2. We cannot have a superficial studying experience. We must dig deep and compare scripture with scripture. If we are in these courts and we really don't know how to teach what we believe, we're going to become confused. And who is confusion? Who is confused? Babylon. We will go out from among us and join the ranks of Babylon. Every position of our faith will be searched into. This includes the teaching that 30 days are in a biblical month. And if we are not thorough Bible students, established, strengthened, settled, the wisdom of the world's great men will be too much for us. Three Selected Messages, 386, paragraph 2. Some of the greatest scholars are going to be brought before us in these courts. And if we don't know our Bibles, brothers and sisters, they're going to make us look like we really don't know anything. So we really need to be digging deep. First, we're going to look in Genesis. In the 600th year of Noah's life, in the second month, the 17th day of the month, the same day were all the fountains of the great deep broken up, and the windows of heaven were opened. Genesis 7:11. So notice it's the 600th year, second month, and 17th day of the month. And the waters prevailed upon the earth 150 days. So from the day it started to rain to the time it stopped raining and it dried up was 150 days. Genesis 7:24. And after the end of the 150 days, the waters were abated. Genesis 8:3. And the ark rested in the seventh month on the 17th day of the month upon the mountains of Ararat. So you had the second month, 17th day of the month, and after 150 days, you're now at the seventh month, 17th day of the month. So, it's the 600 years, second month, 17th day of the month of Noah's life, plus 150 days, takes us to the 600 year, seventh month, 17th day of the month. And that equals exactly 5 months. It's the same year, same day of the month, except the months are different. So from the second month to the seventh month, you have 5 months. 150 days divided by 5 months equals 30 days in each month. So here's one witness. Now we're going to look at Revelation 11. We're counseled in 2 Corinthians 13, 1 or 2, that out of the mouth of two or three witnesses let every word be established. We're about to look at our second witness. And the holy city shall they tread underfoot 42 months, 40 and 2 months. Revelation 11:2. And I will give power unto my two witnesses, and they shall prophesy 1,260 days clothed in sackcloth. Revelation 11:3. 42 months equals 1,260 biblical days. 1,260 days divided by 42 months equals 30 days. There are 30 days in a biblical month. A score equals 20. So 1,203 score days is 1,203 times 20, which would be 60. It's 1,260 days. And 30 days times 12 months equals 360 days in one biblical year. See, there's 365 days in a solar year, according to the Gregorian calendar. But in the biblical year, in the Bible, there's 360 days in a year. And this is very important for us to understand. And when we study the time, times, and half a time, we're going to be learning more about this. The end. Any questions? If so, please post in the comments section below this video. Thank you so much for watching. Lord bless.